Hey there guys, today I'm going to be showing you how to install a client-side mod for Minecraft. It's pretty straightforward. Once you do it one time, I'm sure you'll get the hang of it eventually. I'm sure you'll get the hang of it right away. It's not that hard at all. It does seem very complicated when you read all these forms and directions and everything, but I'll show you how to get everything to work just right. Alright, so I just deleted my .minecraft folder because I wanted to start off clean, so I'm just going to regenerate my .minecraft folder real quickly. And you can see it's downloading the package. I like the way I said that. Alright, so as you can see, it updated the Minecraft. Now, most client mods are going to require you to use Mod Loader. And I'll put a link in the description for Mod Loader. You're just going to want to... Alright, well, here, I'm going to show you... Let's start on the tutorial. Alright, so first, you're going to want to open up your start menu and type in %appdata%. I'm going to hit Enter. It's going to bring me into this folder. The path is C users John app data roaming, and that's for Windows 7. I think for XP it would be like C documents and settings users whatever your name is. I don't know, something like that. But I'm gonna click on the .minecraft folder. I'm gonna go into my bin. Now here's where a kind of like a zip programmer would come into play real nicely. I use WinZip. WinZip is very nice. 7-Zip, I'm almost positive 7-Zip does not... You could open the jars with 7-Zip, but you can't put files inside of them. So you may or may not need to invest a little bit of money in WinZip. I'm not sure if there's a freeware out there that'll do the same thing. So I'm going to right-click on the Minecraft.jar. I'm going to click open because I already had the default program set to WinZip. If you weren't going to click open, I think you click open with and choose a default program and find your WinZip installation. So, now, this is going to open up this, this is my Minecraft.jar. This is inside the Minecraft.jar. So, what I'm going to do first is I'm going to search for my mod loader download. Again, look for the links in the description. Mod Loader did update, luckily, either yesterday or today to 1.7.2. Now I'm gonna Mod Loader is gonna come in a zip. You're gonna unzip that into a folder, and I'm gonna click on my Mod Loader folder. And I'm gonna do the split screen here. I'm going to highlight everything and drag them into what I usually like to do. Make sure that the Minecraft.jar part over here is highlighted, because that just means that it's extracting it into the root folder. And if there were any other folders, they would match. There's never any folders in Mod Loader itself, but they would match one of these folders, and it would just copy everything into the correct folder. So I like to do this. Alright, and of course you gotta have Minecraft.jar closed when you do this. Double check, make sure you do that. I've done it before. And it'll just give you like an error, like it cannot create an output file. I've done it plenty of times before. It's nothing harmful. You don't even have to close WinZip, you just close your Minecraft and it'll work again. Alright, so now we have Mod Loader installed. I generally install two plugins, WorldEdit and Zans Mini-Map. WorldEdit is a little buggy right now because I did have to get it off of his GitHub repo. So it doesn't work the first time sometimes. Very buggy. Zans Mini-Map does work though, very well. So that's going to be a good example to show you guys. Alright, I have two Zans folders, I think. I just want to make sure I open up the right one. And I'm pretty sure this is the right one. So I'm going to open up the folder. And look, remember what I was saying before about how if you open up the folder and there's another folder inside of it? That's why I like to highlight the Minecraft.jar. Because you have this net folder and this net folder. Here it is. Alright, here, I'm going to show you. I'm going to select everything. I'm going to drag it into here. And I'm going to make sure that the Minecraft that jar is highlighted. When I do that, it's just going to take all those net files in the net folder and put them inside the net folder inside your Minecraft.jar. So I'm just going to add everything into there. You can see it worked well. Now, I'm going to do world edit. Let me find my world edit. That's not it. That's it. No folders, but I'm still going to do what I did for the last two. Alright, I'm going to make sure Minecraft.jar is highlighted. I'm going to add them in. Everything went good. Alright, now this is important that you do this. Otherwise, I'll show you what happens if you don't do what I'm going to tell you to do. Let's open up our Minecraft. And let's log in. Now this is just an example, don't actually do this. But you'll get a black screen and you'll get stuck here. So make sure you watch me carefully. I'm gonna alright, I left it open, alright. So I'm gonna reopen up my Minecraft.jar. Now you're gonna go into the meta-inf folder. Make sure you're in here, and you're going to find the manifest.mf file, and we're going to delete that. I'm going to hit yes. I'm going to close. Alright, now my Minecraft.jar should open. Now my Minecraft should open, sorry. I'm going to hit login. As you can see, it started booting up. I'm gonna go to my maybe I'm not. I'll just create a new world in single player. Make this full screen. Shouldn't have done that. There we go. Alright, and as you can see, Zans mod loaded, Zans Mini-Map. I'm gonna make sure that's pretty obnoxious, okay. Alright, and you're gonna hit Z to get rid of that. And as you can see, I do have a mini-map now in the corner of my screen. Let's try world edit. Like I said, it doesn't always work the first time. I'm just gonna do slash, oh yeah, that's right. World edit, whatever you call it. The world edit plugin only works on multiplayer. So I'm just going to, grab my IP address. You guys can feel free to connect to this IP whenever you want. 173.233.66.203. Port number 25568. Alright, allow. Logging in. Alright, now let's see if it'll work right away. Like I said, doesn't always. I'm gonna do / wand. As you can see, it gave me a wooden axe. Nope. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to close this. And I'm going to just restart my Minecraft to get that to work. Like I said, this shouldn't happen once an official build is released for that plugin. But for now, oh my god, you got to be kidding me with this. I hate it when this happens. Drives me insane. Yeah, I don't know. I've been having a lot of internet issues lately. Get out of here. Thank you. Alright, as you can see, my selection's still there from before. And as you can see, it worked. I doubt I'll ever get it to work like that again. No, I'm kidding. And, as you can see, all my mods were installed successfully. I hope this tutorial helped you a lot. Thank you for watching my videos, and I hope to see you again next time. We're losing daylight, but